Ladies and gentlemen, of course, the most effective measure to reduce energy, it's not used energy, but it's like a joke, but in principle, energy efficiency is the most fairest of energy policies, as we are discussing it on, not only reduces emissions, it's also is cost effective, especially in the longer term, increases energy security, offers opportunities for new jobs, new innovations, and so on. But from the other point of view, it's very difficult in some cases to implement the most efficient way, the most attractive way. So I will not discuss in details because it's, how to say, very, very difficult to describe the station and the changes, what we have. But I will try to show energy efficiency changes in the Baltic state to have comparison, and you see that station is very similar, although the countries are very different. And about energy efficiency savings in Lithuania and why it is important, and what could be maybe the major challenges for our country. So, in principle, one specific feature is the same for all Baltic countries. In comparison with Nordic countries, that legacy of central planning, and this exactly not all is presented here, but those factors very important for lack of energy efficiency in the former time. And since 1990s, exactly we had enormous changes in energy efficiency, and do many changes in structure of our economies. But even since 2000s, we have again very large reduction of energy intensity. Why so large in Lithuania, I will show a little later on. But if to see final energy intensity, so situation is again very similar in all three countries, and we have reduction by approximately 20% in compared with 2000 year. But everybody of you know that in the Eurostat indicators are like here, and I think this is the most bad signal to policymakers, because according to the understanding, we have huge potential. Twice and more times we can reduce consumption of energy. This is not motivation to make efforts and to try to analyze what can we do and how shall we do. So much more realistic, I think, are indicators from International Energy Agency. Then we have that this potential is not so large when GDP is measured in purchasing power parities. But of course, potential exists. I would say that according to provisions in our national independence energy strategy, that we expect increase of energy efficiency in all areas, and each year 1.5% is like potential for reduction of energy efficiency in final consumption. And the major contribution is expected from household, public sector, transport, and manufacturing. Exactly those three sectors are important for all three Baltic states. If we will have no changes in those three sectors, our final consumption will be not reduced in the short term in particular. And as an illustration, I have for you indicators how different is the situation in energy consumption per square meter in different houses. We have some share of buildings, about 20%, then we have very good performance. And like if in the previous slides, we have approximately 100 kilowatt hours per square meters. But we have old houses, as you see, more than 50% with 25 kilowatt hours per 1 month, or even 35 kilowatt hours per 1 month. So those buildings are especially important to have results. And here I expect we will have major progress. If to simply look to expected or planned energy savings, so the most important in according to this obligation are horizontal measures, but my understanding is that the major contribution will be, as I said, from household, transport, and industry sectors, and in total it's expected that we will save about 7% from consumption, final consumption in 2011. And why this, let's say, is important for Lithuania in particular. As you can see, we have dramatic changes. We are exporting electricity, and now we have import of electricity more than 60% or even 80%. And due to this reason, we have a situation that we have very large reduction of primary energy. And if to look simply primary energy used for electricity and district generation, we have, let's say, close to zero. Only primary energy used for district heating, because in principle, electricity is mostly from renewables and only a small contribution from natural gas in district heating systems. So our contribution for reduction in this sector are very limited or even opposite. If to have, let's say, more attractive security, we should maybe increase production at our internal power plants, and let's say, consumption of energy will even increase. So the most important for us is that in this case, in 2011, we have the largest contribution from natural gas. Petroleum products are used only in transportation sector and refinery needs. So all changes in electricity generation and district heat generation are currently based on natural gas, which is very expensive and so on. So the other issue, as I think a challenge, as in the previous presentation, was changes in GDP and energy consumption in Latvia. Here we have in Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania. Everywhere situation is such that when our GDP is increasing, our, let's say, energy also is increasing. So I would expect that for the countries which are expecting to reach average of the EU in economic development, could be a simple implication, obligation to reduce energy consumption in absolute terms. And another issue is change in greenhouse emissions. If we have changed since 1990 to 2010, Baltic States are in a very good position. But if we would analyze since 2000s, we see that we have higher emissions than it was in 2000s. So for the future, I would expect we should rate very carefully our possibilities and to be enough flexible, assuming our obligations for future changes in energy efficiency and energy consumption. Thank you.